Yes, the supreme Japanese naval commander, Admiral Isoroku Yamamoto, mastermind of the dastardly sneak attack on Pearl Harbor, gunned from the skies of the South Pacific by these Army Air Corps flyers. These brave sky fighters of the 339th, 70th, and 12th Fighter Squadrons realized that they and their lightnings wrote a chapter that history may regard as the turning point of this war. April 18th, 1943, while evading attacks from escorting Zeros, Captain Tom Lanphier, Lieutenant Besby Holmes, and Lieutenant Rex Barber brought down two bombers transporting Yamamoto and his staff. Days earlier, an alert radio operator intercepts the secret message listing Yamamoto's flight schedule to the Bougainville airfield, 435 miles north of Guadalcanal. The code cracked. The Admiral has no chance of making it. No chance, thanks to our boys, ready to give their lives in the perils of the sky. Major John Mitchell plans the daring mission. He has to have these men over Bougainville at the precise moment Yamamoto is to arrive. Mitchell knows that the Admiral is a very punctual man. Since timing is very critical, he will navigate only by compass and clock. No one knows how many fighters will be waiting for them. Sure, you'd be nervous too. No rationing here, fellas. They'll need plenty of that precious stuff for the 900-mile round trip. Head out from Guadalcanal that morning. 12 planes will take care of any enemy fighters, and 4 lightnings will smash Yamamoto's bombers. Two hours later, and only a minute off schedule, the pilots make landfall. There it is, and there's the target. Lanphier and Rex Barber heading for Yamamoto. The Japanese learn that Yankee lightning strikes hard and fast. Once on his tail, Lieutenant Barber keeps to his gun. Look at this spectacle. Barber relentlessly hammers the bomber into the jungle. A fiery end for Japan's greatest military mind. Thanks to these brave warriors, that 18th day of April brings our forces a day closer to victory.